Well, good afternoon, all my loyal followers of Village Stage Caravan Capers. Yes, I'm here live, absolutely live, in a field somewhere, no technology being used whatsoever, and I'm going to bring you a live show today. I've got some I'm recording live on Facebook to the whole world here. Would you mind going away? Yes, you. Yeah, I don't know. I didn't want to talk to people on caravan sites. Just go away and don't be rude. Honestly, I mean, people on caravan sites, they just wander over. So anyway, I'm sitting here just about to munch on one of Annie Gregg's famous Australian-style rock cakes. She delivered them to me in the caravan park. She drove all the way to where I am in the caravan park and delivered me these rock cakes. I won't put it in my mouth yet because I'll spit it all over the microphone. Anyway, I've got some lovely music for you. I've got an interview. I've got a memory, and I'm going to be following the entire show myself in comments so that we can catch up, have conversation, and I can say hello to everybody who's watching. So with no further ado, I'm going to move on and start the show. I'll talk to you all later. Bye. Hi, everybody, and welcome to Village Stage Caravan Capers, episode 3. Yes, here I am back in the field in Wiltshire, having been to Wales and having met a person that I interviewed that I'm going to present later on. I'm back here and I'm sitting in my caravan, setting up as a studio and having some fun. I'll probably be home by the weekend when I actually stream this because the weather's about to change, but you won't know because I'll have the green screen and make it look like I'm still in the caravan. I will cheat. That's one of the secrets of my technology. Yeah, very clever stuff. Anyway, today, the gentleman I've interviewed is a folk singer. So I thought I might theme a lot of the songs I do today, sort of folky, or at least storytelling. And I'm going to start off with something that I haven't done live for a long, long time. You may like it, you may not. It's a bit different. I'm going to actually, even though I've got some reverb on here now, I'm going to give it a tad more reverb before I do this. Here we go. Dumbarton's drums, they sound so bonny, and they remind me of my genie. Such fond delight doth steal upon me when a genie kneels and kisses me. Across the fields of bounding heather, Dumbarton tolls the hour of pleasure, a song of love that's without measure, when genie sings her songs to me. She teaches a love that can delight me, a roving eye, it doth invite me. And when her tender arms involve me, the blackest night does turn and flee. My genie is a handsome lassie, and though I am Dumbarton's caddy, someday she'll be a captain's lady when genie turns her vows to me. Dumbarton's drums, they sound so bonny, and they remind me of my genie. Such fond delight doth steal upon me when genie kneels and kisses me. When genie kneels and kisses me. Turn that reverb back down again. And I got that song from a wonderful singer who unfortunately died at such a young age. His name was John Wright. And I picked up an album of his somewhere along the way. And oh my goodness, I loved it. If ever you want to hear an album, Language of the Heart, I think, is the album. John Wright, absolutely amazing. And I actually had some people on Village Stage Lunchtime Live, Liz and Dave Wormsley, and Dave played in the John Wright band. So there you go. Here's one just to kick us along a little bit. Something a bit more foot-tappy. Well, it ain't no use to sit and wonder why, babe. It don't matter anyhow. Well, it ain't no use to sit and wonder why, babe. If you don't know by now, at the break of dawn, look out your window and I'll be
gone. You're the reason I'm traveling on. Don't think twice, it's all right. Ain't no use turning out your light, babe. That light I've never known. Well, ain't no use turning on your light, babe. I'm on the dark side of the road. Still, I wish there was something you would do or say to try and make me change my mind and make me wanna stay. Well, we never did too much talking anyway. Don't think twice, it's all right. Well, it ain't no use calling out my name, babe. Like you never did before. And ain't no use just calling out my name, babe. 'Cause I can't hear you anymore. I'm a thinking and a wondering, walking all on down the road. I once loved a woman, had a child, I'm told. I gave her my heart, but she wanted my soul. Don't think twice, it's all right. So long, honey, babe. Where I'm bound, I just can't tell. But goodbye's too good a word, so I'll just say fare thee well. Well, I accept that you treated me unkind. You could have done better, but I don't mind. You just wasted my precious time. Don't think twice, it's all right. Well, you just wasted my precious time. Don't think twice, it's all right.
That's a bit bouncier. In fact, it's so bouncy, it wears me out. Might have to go back to another slow song after I've cleared my throat. Okay, here's a song. I'm not quite sure how it's going to work out because every time I try it, it seems to come out different. But it's a song by Robin Lang, and it's actually another song off the John Wright album. I just realised that. Done by a few people. There's a long road before me, trying to unwind the distance and the dislocation dragging on my mind. I think she might be near me, that girl I left behind. And I realize, yes, I'm only dreaming. I could call her on the telephone 100 times a day and listen closely, lovingly to anything she'd say. But that would just remind me that she's so far away. If only I could travel in my dream. 'Cause when she wears black clothes,
She wraps me like the night. Her hair is dark and dusky, and her laughing eyes are bright. She wears black clothes. She can do just what she likes. She makes a living on this earth all like dreaming. I wish I had a hologram packed up in my case, and any time I wanted I could see her smiling face, and for a moment slip away from this singer's marketplace, and concentrate on wishing hard and dreaming. 'Cause when she wears black clothes, she wraps me like the night. Her hair is dark and dusky, and her laughing eyes are bright. When she wears black clothes, she can do just what she likes. She makes a living on this earth all like dreaming. Now licorice is sweet, if that's the kind of thing you like. And there's promise and there's danger in every oil stride. But graceful and mysterious, like a jet black Japanese kite, is the shadow of this raven in my dreaming. When she wears black clothes, she wraps me like the night. Her hair is dark and dusky, and her laughing eyes are bright. When she wears black clothes, she can do just what she likes. She makes a living on this earth more like dreaming. She makes a living on this earth more like dreaming.
Black clothes. I shall listen back to that to see whether I like it. But other than that, it's time to move on. We've got our interview coming up, and I'm not going to tell you who it is until you watch the next set. So, without further ado, here is the interview of the week.
Hi, ladies and gentlemen, Village Stage, Caravan Capers, episode 3. Now, here I am in Wales. Yes, I'm in Wales, the birthplace of the world's best and most famous singers. We've got Harry Secombe, Tom Jones, Bryn Terfel, Shirley Bassey, Mary Hopkins, and the amazing Greg Rowlands. So here he is. Here he is, Greg. I'm pleased to have you with me. Thanks for having me, Greg.
Yeah, cheers.
So, Greg, how does it feel to be listed amongst those greats?
There's probably some fabrication of the truth in this, and whether it feels all right, yeah.
It feels all right. Well, that's good. seriously, Greg, we met at the Newport Folk Club, what, 2 or 3 years ago? At least two or three years ago. And I loved your singing. I really did. And you've done a spot for me on Lunchtime Live last year.
Which I thoroughly enjoyed.
But professionally, most of your life you've been a farmer. So is that kind of Has music been the relief from farming, or farming the relief from music?
Well, most of my life, my working life, my daytime job was with the local authority, but I was brought up on the farm. And I've always had an interest in agriculture and still have. We don't farm anymore, but we've always sung as a family. My mother was a great singer. My maternal grandmother was a great singer.
Right.
And we sang in the car, we sang in the house, we sang everywhere.
Oh, lovely.
That's what started it all off, I think.
So how would you describe your music? What sort of music did you play, and what influences do you prefer to use?
I like all sorts of music. I like good music. I like music generally that tells a story. I started off way back when in the rock and roll era, because I'm getting on a bit now. started way back as a rock and roller, and then went into folk music during the 60s.
Didn't we all go into folk music in the 60s?
alongside the folk music, then I was going on to heavy metal and so on. I was a great fan of Joni Mitchell when she started, James Taylor, Carole King, all the sort of stalwarts of where we are today, really.
How have you been coping during the pandemic with not being able to perform live? Because we all love to perform live, don't we? I mean, that's what it's all about.
So. Well, most of the time, like everybody else, we sing to a computer screen. And I think, fortunately, technology has helped music in general. If it had been 20, 25 years ago, we would probably have seen the demise of our music gatherings. But at least now, the technology has allowed people to stay together, even though it's only virtual. And hopefully, as soon as it's over, we can get back to being amongst friends and singing our songs and joining each other.
Because you actually do perform at festivals and things, don't you? So do you think that'll all get back to normal, the festival scene and the open mic folk club scene?
So. Yeah, I'm sincerely hoping so. The festivals are a great part of folk life, but we must never, ever forget the folk clubs and the wonderful people who run the folk clubs and provide us with a forum to go and sing and provide us with our guests that they book for the clubs, and most of them do it for nothing anyway.
We talked about that with Jude Beverly last week, and she runs a folk club, and she does it, and I jokingly said to her, you know, how have you managed without the money? But she said it actually costs her more to put it on than she makes out of it.
But it's a dedication to music. And
do you think the folk club scene is going to continue? Do you think it's got a lifespan?
Well, if you look at the demographic of folk clubs, we're all getting towards shutdown somewhere. But, you know, I'm really seriously hoping that younger people will take over. I mean, if you go to a folk festival, there's a lot of young people there.
Yeah, that's good, isn't it?
So where do
it's
they
encouraging.
Go? It is encouraging, but where do they go in between festivals?
Yeah, I go to a number of folk clubs, and I think the same thing, that majority of people in the room are, let's say, senior.
Well, yeah, that's a polite way of putting it. At least we're all staying together and we're all friends. And the folk scene is a very friendly, genuine place as far as I'm concerned. Yeah.
Now, Greg, you did mention on the phone yesterday you've got a birthday coming up and something special's happening.
Oh, is it?
Well, I don't know. You tell me.
I'm going to be 68. That's not very special, but
you've got some musicals.
What we've actually done is that we've been very fortunate, Lindsay, who is my wife and myself, to meet up and be friends with very good musicians and the professional musicians, and a lot of them have stayed here with us. So for Lindsay's birthday back in March, we got Pete Morton to do a Zoom night for us, and we invited a group of friends to enjoy Pete's music. And for my birthday, we've got Kip and Dave Winter Wilson, who are absolutely awesome guys.
They've been on Village Stage. They're lovely.
They're awesome. Yeah. They're great people, good friends of ours, and they're going to do a night for us for my birthday.
Fabulous.
In a couple of weeks' time.
Yeah. And the other thing, you're also, like me, a bit of a travelling bard. You've got a motorhome and you drift around. Do you do things like me? Do you look for places to sing before you look to where you're going to camp, or do you look to where you're going to camp and then go and find a folk club?
I have a very, very keen wife, who generally looks around to see if we can find anywhere to sing. And if there's anywhere remotely near, we're prepared to go and torture them with this old Welsh voice.
About torture.
And generally, we've made lovely friends throughout the country by visiting folk clubs and little gatherings and festivals and so on.
Great. Okay. Well, look, talking about that old voice of yours, what about, as a special treat to our viewers today, we give them a performance of that song that I love you doing, "For Now I'm Just a Country Boy." Because you are, aren't you? Just
a country boy. A country boy.
I'm going to swing the camera over here. Ladies and gentlemen, Greg's going to do a song for us. Here we go.
This is "I'm Just a Country Boy." I ain't gonna marry in the fall, I ain't gonna marry in the spring, for I'm in love with a pretty little girl who wears a diamond ring. For I'm just a country boy, money have I none, but I've got silver in the stars, gold in the morning sun, gold in the morning sun. I'm never gonna kiss those ruby red lips, the prettiest little girl in town. I'm not gonna ask her if she'll marry me, 'cause I know she'll turn me down. 'Cause I'm just a country boy, money have I none, but I've got silver in the stars, gold in the morning sun, gold in the morning. I never could afford a store-bought ring with its sparkling diamond stones. All I can afford is a loving heart, the only one I own. For I'm just a country boy, money have I none, but I've got silver in the stars, gold in the morning sun, gold in the morning sun. No, I ain't gonna marry in the fall, I ain't gonna marry in the spring, for I'm in love with a pretty little girl who wears a diamond ring. For I'm just a country boy, money have I none, but I've got silver in the stars, gold in the morning sun, gold in the morning sun.
Well, thank you, Greg. That was absolutely beautiful. In fact, if we'd have rehearsed that, I would have harmonied that chorus line with you, but I didn't want to come in and spoil it. Thank you for the interview. Thank you for your lunch. Thank your wife for lunch. And hopefully, maybe, with your camper, you'll get over to Angmering one day and we'll give you a spot at the village stage.
Okay, thanks so much, Jeff, for taking the trouble to come and see me.
No, thank you for having me. See ya. Thank you. Bye, everyone.
Well, welcome back. And yeah, there was an interview with Mr. Greg Rowland, a lovely man who made me very welcome in his home with his lovely wife, Lindsay. And I thank you for that, Greg. And I hope you send that interview to all of your friends in the Newport Folk Club, who I had the joy of meeting some time ago. Okay, moving right along.
We're going to get back to a bouncy old folk song now, just for your sake, because I know that Jill and Marilyn and Claire and Nikki and Christine and Steph, I know you all love to sing along and bounce to my songs. Well, here's a bouncy one. It's a lesson too late for the learning, made of sand, made of sand. In the wake of an eye, my soul is turning. In your hand, in your hand. Are you going away with no word of farewell? Will there be not a trace left behind? Well, I could have loved you better, didn't mean to be unkind. You know that was the last thing on my mind. You got reasons aplenty for going. This I know, this I know. All the weeds have been steadily growing. Please don't go. No, please don't go. Are you going away with no word of farewell? Will there be not a trace left behind? Well, I could have loved you better, didn't mean to be unkind. You know that was the last thing on my mind. Walk on, my thoughts keep a tumbling round and round, round and round. Underneath our feet, the subway's rumbling underground, underground. Are you going away with no word of farewell? Will there be not a trace left behind? Well, I could have loved you better, didn't mean to be unkind. I know that was the last thing on my mind. I know that was the last thing on my mind. As I lie in my bed in the morning without you, without you. Every song in my breast lies a morning without you, without you. Are you going away with no word of farewell? There be not a trace left behind. Well, I could have loved you better, didn't mean to be unkind. No, that was the last thing on my mind. Well, I could have loved you better, didn't mean to be unkind. You know that was the last thing on my mind. There you go, with a bit of license thrown in. I hope you all foot tapped and everything to that one, because this one is a melancholy, non-foot tapping song. One of my favourite songs that I picked up along the way. And it's called The Dutchman. I've done it before. And it's been covered by a number of people, and there are a number of interpretations of what it means. The one that I favour is that it's about a man who's probably shell-shocked from the war. And he's probably come back and he's lost his memory, not through dementia, because there are some lines in the song that reflect the way he relates to his wife. But nevertheless, it's a beautiful song, and it's called The Dutchman. And the chorus line is very melancholy. It's him reflecting on him wanting to go to the ocean. So if you want to sing along that part, please do. The Dutchman's not the kind of man to keep his thumb jammed in the dam that holds
holds his dreams in. But that's a secret only Margaret knows. When Amsterdam is golden in the morning, Margaret brings him breakfast. She believes him. He thinks the tulips bloom beneath the snows. He's mad as he can be, but Margaret only sees that sometimes. Sometimes she sees her unborn children in his eyes. Let us go to the banks of the ocean, where the walls rise above the Zuider Zee. Long ago, I used to be a young man, and dear Margaret remembers that from me. The Dutchman still wears wooden shoes. His cap and coat are patched with the love that Margaret sewed there. Sometimes he thinks he's still in Rotterdam. He watches tugboats down canals and calls out to them when he thinks he knows the captain. Till Margaret comes to take him home again, through unforgiving streets that trip him though she holds his arm. Sometimes he thinks he's alone and calls her name. Let us go to the banks of the ocean, where the walls rise above the Zuider Zee. Long ago, I used to be a young man, and dear Margaret remembers that from me. The windmills swirl the winter wind, she winds his muffler tighter. They sit in the kitchen, and a tea with whiskey keeps away the dew. He sees her for a moment, calls her name. She makes the bed up, singing some old love song. She learned it when the tune was very new. He hums a line or two. They hum together in the night. The Dutchman falls asleep and Margaret blows the candle out. Let us go to the banks of the ocean, where the walls rise above the Zuider Zee. Long ago, I used to be a young man, and dear Margaret remembers that from me. Let us go to the banks of the ocean, where the walls rise above the Zuider Zee. Long ago, I used to be a young man, and dear Margaret remembers that from me. Thank you.
The Dutchman. I don't know about my singing, but isn't that a beautiful song? Just listen to some other verses of it, some other versions of it. A beautiful song. Okay, we're moving on now. It's time for my memory. Yes, a playback of something I did way back in history. Well, it's only been going just over a year. Anyway, way back then. So here it comes. My choice of a memory. See you later.
I'm in the garden today. I'm going to do a bit of gardening, so I thought I'd do it to music. And this is a song called The Garden Song. And I've got a couple of friends might turn up as well. Give me a hand.
Inch by inch, row by row. Inch by inch, row by row.
Inch by inch, row by row, gonna make this garden grow. All it takes is a rake and a hoe and a piece of fertile ground. Inch by inch, row by row, someone bless the seeds I sow. Someone warm them from below till the rain comes tumbling down.
Inch by inch,
come on, Mike, row get on with row. It. Yeah, I'm not a very good gardener. Some people have got green fingers. Mine are just pink. But anyway, I suppose before I plant anything, I should dig up some old stuff and get some weeds out. You ready, guys?
Yep.
Pulling weeds, picking stones, man is made of dreams and bones. Feel the need to grow my own, cause the time is close at hand. Grain for grain, sun and rain, find my way in nature's chain. To my body and my brain, from the music of the land.
Inch by inch, row by row.
So I'll pop down to Haskins and have a look around the shop. Winter, I thought, get some winter plants. So I looked for these things, and they were potted pansies. Very cheap. Really cheap. Quite pretty. There's a bunch of other pansies there too, but I didn't get them. I wanted the potted type. So I left it at that. And brought a few home. You know you got to do next, don't you? You've got to stick them in. Plant your roots straight and long, thicker than with prayer and song. Mother Earth will make you strong if you give her love and care. Okra watching hungrily from his perch in yonder tree. In my garden I'm as free as that feathered beef up there.
Inch by inch, row by row.
But you know what?
Inch by
they all died.
Inch,
yep.
Row by row.
Didn't take them long. The frost, I think, might have got them. Down the gurgler they went. Do you know what I'm going to do next year? I'm going to go to IKEA and buy some flat, pat, potted pansies. Plastic ones. Yeah. Ready, guys? Inch by inch, row by row, gonna make this garden grow. All it takes is a rake and a hoe and a piece of fertile ground. Inch by inch, row by row, someone bless the seeds I sow. Someone warm them from below till the rain comes tumbling down. And again, inch by inch, row by row, gonna make this garden grow. All it takes is a rake and a hoe and a piece of fertile ground. Inch by inch, row by row, someone bless the seeds I sow. Someone warm them from below till the rain comes tumbling down. Till the rain comes tumbling down.
Inch by inch, row by row. Inch by inch, row by row.
When you finish.
Inch by inch.
Till the rain comes tumbling down.
Row by row. Inch by inch.
Hey, wait. Hey, you guys. The song's finished.
Inch
it's finished. What's the matter with you?
Row
it's
row.
Finished.
Inch oh. By inch.
You're
row
gone.
By row, inch by
that'll show them. Till the rain comes tumbling down. The Garden Song with my Muppets. Bye-bye.
That was one I enjoyed doing way back. It must have been last summer because I was out in the garden. And those silly idiots joined me, and I've since poisoned them, and they've died off. So that's good. We won't be seeing them again. And I played that one for Christine because Christine accidentally, without her knowledge, got roped into being one of those Muppets one time, didn't you, Christine? And you hated it. But she did it, God bless her. Thank you for that. Okay, I'm going to do a song now by somebody who could be called a folk singer because his songs tell stories. It's Chris de Burg. And this is the story of why Mona Lisa smiled. From candles burning, shadows in the night, people praying for eternal life, but my mind just keeps on wandering away from this serene and hallowed place to a woman's face. She was lovely, lovely as a dream. She had the beauty of a queen. They say that every man who meets her sooner or later will fall, even me that they call the master of invention, the painter of our time. I can take you round the heavens and show you how to fly. Was a moment caught forever, there was something in her eyes, but I wish I could remember why Mona Lisa smiled. Sat before me, this woman so divine. Something eternal was shining in her eyes. Only said, "Al Giocondo, you've opened up a world of mystery when you were looking at me." The master of invention, the painter of our time. I can take you round the heavens and show you how to fly. Was a moment caught forever, there was something in her eyes, but I wish I could remember why Mona Lisa smiled. Shame the devil in my heart, but I can't stop thinking about her. Oh, what she's doing to me, what she's doing to me. Was a moment of perfection, the canvas never lies, but I wish I could remember why Mona Lisa smiled. Why Mona Lisa smiled. Why Mona Lisa smiled. Why Mona Lisa smiled. Why did Mona Lisa smile? No idea. Who was in that studio to know? Oh, I hope Jimmy Lee's watching, because here's a foot tapper. Sun on the Shannon, she rode beside me. This beautiful girl with green eyes and black hair. Questions and answers, exchanging glances, punctuated with silence as we rode on to Clare.
When we got to Clare Castle, our journey was over. She smiled and said, thank you. I said, not at all. Then from under her eyelids, she ventured to ask me, would I take her that night to Lanark to the ball? Would you take one more dance with me, honey? Would you take one more dance with me? I could meet you there in the County Clare. Would you take one more dance with me? I could meet you there in the County Clare. Would you take one more dance with me? Just for a moment, stood there in silence. How could I say no to this lovely calling? I'd be proud to go with you, I ventured to answer. Please tell me your name, sure my name is Eileen. We danced through the evening and into the morning. I could not believe she was dancing with me. Once more round the floor, I swept the young Eileen. In my arms I was holding the rose of Tralee. Would you take one more dance with me, Eileen? Would you take one more dance with me? I could meet you there in the County Clare. Would you take one more dance with me? If I could meet you there in the County Clare, would you take one more dance? Fairy style story, tiaras and glory. She reigned for 1 year, did that young beauty queen. But not so long after, tears mixed with laughter, when I had to say goodbye to Eileen. Long years have passed since I had to leave Ireland, that beautiful girl who by chance rode with me. I'll never forget her, or the way that I met her, that girl from Clare Castle, the Rose of Tralee. Would you take one more dance with me, Eileen? Would you take one more dance with me? If I could meet you there in the County Clare, would you take one more dance with me? I could take one more dance with me, Eileen. Would you take one more dance with me? If I could meet you there in the County Clare, would you take one more dance with me? If I could meet you there in the County Clare, would you take one more dance with me? I'll never forget her, or the way that I met her, that girl from Clare Castle, the Rose of Tralee.
Eileen, courtesy of Jimmy Lee and his life story. Thank you, Jimmy. Mucked a couple of chords up there, but you know, it's live theatre, mate. Or maybe I'll get you to do it. Okay, ladies and gentlemen. That is the end of the show, apart from the sing-along that should just get you going. I haven't rehearsed it, but it should work. So thank you for joining me. I hope to keep Caravan Capers going, even though I'll be at home for a little while. I will be off again soon, so I might use some technical magic to make it look like I'm in the caravan and continue doing some under the guise of Village Stage Caravan Capers. So for now, I'm just going to say hello, which is my way of saying goodbye.
I said hello, Mary Lou. Goodbye, heart, sweet Mary Lou. I'm so in love with you. I knew Mary Lou, we'd never part. So hello, Mary Lou. Goodbye, heart. Passed me by one sunny day,
Flash those big brown eyes my way, and ooh, I wanted you forevermore. I'm not the one who gets around, swear my feet stuck to the ground, and though I never did meet you before. There we go. I said hello, Mary Lou. Goodbye, heart, sweet Mary Lou, I'm so in love with you. Girl, Mary Lou, we never part. So hello, Mary Lou, goodbye, heart. I saw your lips, I heard your voice. Believe me, I had no choice. While the horses couldn't make me stay away, I thought about a moonlit night, arms around you good and tight, and now I had to see for me to stay. Yeah, I said hello, Mary Lou. Goodbye, heart, sweet Mary Lou, I'm so in love with you. I knew Mary Lou, we never part. So hello, Mary Lou, goodbye, heart. Yes, hello, Mary Lou, goodbye, heart. Yeah, hello, Mary Lou, goodbye, heart.
Thank you for joining me. See you here in some order of Village Stage presentations. This time, next Sunday, midday. Catch you soon. Bye! Well, that was fun. I enjoyed watching that and interacting with you all on comments and there. And Eileen just said that she wanted to dance with me. Well, I can tell you one thing, Eileen, that is a big mistake. Oh, unless you want a smooch, I don't mind one of them. That's all right. Anyway, thank you everybody for watching. I'm going to start preparing a show for next week, which you may have guessed I am actually at home. The technology I'm using just puts that picture behind me. It's a bit of a cheat, really. But you never know, I might be somewhere else next week. So anyway, I will leave you with that as I drift off. Tomorrow I'm going travelling to meet somebody for next week's interview, and it will be a good one, absolutely guaranteed. Thank you, Greg, for your time in interviewing, and thank you, everybody, for watching. And I will see you all next week. Take care. Have a good week.